Fox 5 Health News, and we've been telling you about that Legionnaires disease outbreak in Upper Manhattan. The city health department says 8 people in Washington and Hamilton Heights have been diagnosed in the past week alone. Officials are testing water from nearby cooling tower systems. Now, they'll be updating the community tonight at 7 p.m. in Harlem at St. Luke's AME Church, which is on Amsterdam Ave.
All right, joining us now is Dr. Jennifer Caudle, a professor at Rowan University, to tell us about what we need to know about. This is something that seems to happen this time of year.
A lot,
yes. Yeah.
You know, this really is a public health issue, and mm-hmm. you're absolutely right about that. And you mentioned the thing about the cooling systems. That's right. One of the really important things for people to know is that this is a bacteria that typically grows. It likes to grow in either fresh water or man-made cooling systems like, you know, large plumbing systems, et cetera. So that's why we're testing the cooling systems. Very important. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, people inhale those water droplets in the air, and that's how they contract it.
Oh, wow. And so talk to us about the symptoms. What happens?
Right. So, you know, the symptoms can, sometimes they seem almost like flu-like symptoms. You can get cough, shortness of breath, fever, muscle aches, even a headache. I think one of the most important things to know, someone might say, well, how do I know if this is me? And that's why knowing where this outbreak is happening in Manhattan is very important, because it usually tends to be a regional thing, people sharing a similar cooling system. But it can be diagnosed and treated with antibiotics from your doctor, which is a very, very good thing.
Gotcha.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, moving on. Yeah, another clue to Alzheimer's. Researchers say high blood pressure could increase your risk of the disease. We've been hearing more and more about the dangers of high blood pressure in general. Here's just another one.
Right. No, this is so important. And you're right. High blood pressure, we talk about it all the time. It's a risk factor for so many things, heart disease, strokes, heart attacks, et cetera. This was a study I think is really interesting, because researchers wanted to understand if and how there's a connection between blood pressure and Alzheimer's disease and stroke, et cetera. They followed almost 1,300 people who were older individuals for about 8 years or so until death. They followed their blood pressure, et cetera, looked at their brains on autopsy, and those with higher blood pressures tended to have rates of higher elements of brain infarcts, which is a risk factor for strokes, but also tangles, which is a group of proteins that we often find in patients with Alzheimer's disease. So it's kind of an interesting thing that we're seeing here. Complicated, we need more studies, but an interesting connection nonetheless.
Right, another powerful reason to get your blood pressure down, whatever you can do.
Exactly.
Indeed.
Exactly.
Long-term stress in the body. All right, Dr. Jennifer Caudle, we appreciate it. Thank you very much.